the observed routine of the personnel to the alarm system. The type of locks on the doors, the age and condition of the main safe, and so forth and so forth. Take my word for it, Mr. Emmerich. This is a ripe plum ready to fall.
My friend, according to the boys, all takes are easy. But as a lawyer, I've made a lot of money getting them out of jail.
Please, Mr. Emmerich, perhaps you know my reputation. I've engineered some very big things.
That's a fact, Mr. Emmerich. Doc here stops.
Am I to understand that you gathered all this information before doing your last stretch?
That is correct. I was ready to begin operations, and the coppers grabbed me for an old caper I'd almost forgotten about.
The Adelphia Finance caper. You took them for $160,000, didn't you, Doc?
$158,000.
And you really believe there's a million in this thing?
Maybe even more.
You mean by that the take will be worth $500,000 to us in actual cash? Because you know as well as I do that in no case will a fence give you more than 50%.
That's right, sir.
Well, what are your main problems?
There are three. Money to operate, personnel, and finally, the disposing of the take.
No trouble about the first, eh, Mr. Emmerich?
No, wait a minute, Carby. This remains to be seen.
The helpers will be paid off like house painters. They'll be told nothing about the size of the take. Sometimes men get greedy.
Well, how many helpers do you need?
Only three. A boxman. Him we pay most. Maybe $25,000.
I got a guy for you. Louis Civelli. Best boxman west of Chicago. Expert mechanic. Been in some very big capers. From what I hear, he can open a safe like the back of a watch. Only he costs.
Then we need a top-notch driver in case of a rumble. He should get 10,000. Mm-hmm. And finally, sad to say, we need a hooligan. Most of these fellows are drug addicts. They're no good lot or they wouldn't be hooligans. Violence is all they know. But they are, unfortunately, necessary. For a more or less reliable man, I'd say 15,000.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's 50,000 in all. How's this take to be handled?
We'll get in touch with the best fencers in the Midwest and deal with whoever makes the highest offer. Maybe no one fence can handle the whole thing. In that case, we deal with two or three.
$500,000, eh? I'm
just thinking. If I decide to go into this thing, I might handle it.
You a fence, Mr. Emmerich?
No, Cobby, not exactly. But your proposition looks pretty good. I'd like to see the most made of it. Oh, I suppose a fellow should stick to his own trade, but I know some pretty big men around here that might not be averse to a deal like this if they're properly approached. Highly respectable men, I might add. So why don't you let me see what I can do before you look for a fence? A few days more or less wouldn't make much difference to you, I don't suppose. Might mean a lot more money for all of us.
Good. There's just one thing. I dislike to mention it, but I've just come from prison and...
Oh, well, of course, Cobby here will be glad to advance you anything you need. See that you have a place to stay. Hey, Cobby?
Yeah, you bet your life. And I got some fancy phone numbers for you too, Doc.
What's it like, a man of your taste, 7 years behind the walls?
Not too bad. It's a matter of temperament. I cause no trouble. The prison authorities appreciate that. They made me assistant librarian.
I'm afraid I wouldn't make a model prisoner.
After this job, it's Mexico for me. I'll live like a king. Mexican girls are very pretty. I'll have nothing to do all day long but chase them in the sunshine. You've been very kind, sir.
Good night.
Emmerich?
Copy.